In this video, I'll be going over naming ionic compounds, and this is going to be ionic compounds that have Roman numerals, and what that means is that we're dealing with transition metals. So first of all, when we have an ionic compound, that means we have a metal and a nonmetal. And then anytime you see Roman numerals, all that means is that your metal is a transition metal, which means that it's in this part of the periodic table. And that means that it's in the part of the periodic table that we cannot predict its valence electrons, because the first two columns on the left-hand side we can predict, and then the last six on the right-hand side we can predict. But everything in here, we don't know exactly how many valence electrons it's going to have, so we don't know what type of ion it makes. So the rules for this, when you have a transition metal, it's going to be a cation, and it's going to be positive, which is what cation means, and it's going to be first, and you're going to name it just with the element name. And then the Roman numeral tells you the charge of that transition metal. So it just tells you the charge of every one transition metal you have, does not tell you at all how many of that metal you have. So let's start over here with copper 3 oxide. So we have our Roman numeral in the middle, but it's just talking about copper. So what we want to get from this is that we have Cu and 3+. It's always going to be positive if it's a cation, if it's a metal. It's always going to be positive. And so now we have oxide. So to do this, we have to figure out what ion oxygen normally becomes. So for this, we do look at the periodic table. So over here in column number 6, we have oxygen. And so we can see that oxygen is going to gain 2 electrons because it has 6 and wants to get to 8. And so an oxygen ion will be O2-. And so now these are our two pieces, and we just have to figure out how many of each piece do we have until we get a balanced molecule that has a charge of 0. So right now we can see if we added up positive 3 and negative 2, that would get us to 1+, so that wouldn't be balanced at 0. So we'd have to add something that's more negative. So if we added another oxygen, O2-, now our total negative charge is 4- coming from the 2 oxygens, and then 3+ coming from the copper. So now if we added up our total charge, we'd be at 1-, and so we have to need something more positive. So we're going to add another copper 3+. And now if we added up these two, we'd have 6 positive charges coming from the coppers, and we'd have 4-, so we'd be at 2+. So we need something more negative, so we add one more oxygen. And remember, my goal here is just to get it to be completely charge balanced, which means to 0. So now if we add up all of our charges, we have a total of 6 positive charges, and we have then 6 negative charges. And so now we're completely balanced. So it took us to get to a balanced molecule, it took us to have 2 coppers and 3 oxygens. All right. So now let's do silver-2-phosphide. So again, we look at that Roman numeral. All it tells us is that we're going to have a charge of 2. It's always going to be positive for all the metals. So this just means that we have Ag2+ as one of our ions. And now we have phosphide, and that's the one we're going to figure out from the valence electrons. So in all of these, it's only the transition metals that you have to be told. The rest we're just going to figure out from valence electrons and what type of ion it wants to make. So phosphide over here at 5. So it has 5 valence electrons, so it wants to gain 3 to get to 8. So it's going to be P-3. And so now, again, we have to balance these two parts to get to a molecule that has a charge of 0. And so right now we have too many negatives. Negative 3 is more than the positive 2. So we're going to add something else that's positive. Add another Ag2+. Now we have 4+ and 3-. We have to add another negative. And now we have a total of negative 6 from the 2 phosphoruses, positive 2 from the 2 silvers, so we have to add another positive 2. One more silver. And now we have 6+ from the silvers and 6- from the phosphoruses, so now we're ready to have our charge balanced molecule. So this ends up being Ag3, and then we use 2 Ps. All right, so now let's take it from chemical formula to name. So over here, we have V3N, and so we know that N is in our 5th column, so it's going to want to gain 3 valence electrons. So our N becomes an ion of N3-. And then our V, we don't know yet. That's our question mark. So it's our goal to figure out what charge is going to go in this box. And so we don't know what charge is going to go in there, but we do know that we have three of them. So we really have a molecule that looks like this. We're told that we have three V's and then one nitrogen. So now we have to look at these three boxes and look at what number that's positive is going to go into this box that then helps us completely balance out the three minus. And the only number that makes sense is positive one. So if each V has a charge of positive one, then they'll completely cancel out the N3 minus. And so this is going to be our Roman numeral. And so now to name it, our transition metal is just the element name, so just vanadium. Our Roman numeral is one, because that's the charge of each vanadium. And now we're going to turn nitrogen into nitride. All right, and one more. So now we have Ti3, As2, and so I'm going to fill in what we do know. We know we have two arsenics, and so arsenic, again, is in this fifth column. So arsenic wants to form a negative three ion because it wants to get three more electrons. And we're told that we have two arsenics. And then on the other side, we're told we have three titaniums, but we don't know what the charge is yet. And so now we have to look and see what charge is going to fill in so that we overall get to zero. And they can't be different. They all have to have the same exact charge. And so now if we put a plus one in there, the three titaniums would total up to three plus. That wouldn't cancel out the negative six that we have from the negative arsenics. But if we put positive two in there, it'd be plus two, plus two, plus two. So if you tally up all these charges, we get to plus six and to minus six. And now this equals zero, so this is completely balanced. So now we know that this is our Roman numeral. So the name for this chemical would be titanium, Roman numeral two, because each titanium is charged positive two, and then arsenic becomes arsenide. All right, I hope that helped you do some naming with ionic compounds that have Roman numerals. Remember, all that means is that you have transition metals. Good luck, and I promise after you do a few of those practice problems, it'll get easier. Bye-bye.